Hello, I am Professor Dr. Mahipal Singh Sachdev. I am the Chairman and Medical Director of Center for Sight Group of Eye Hospitals. I am the past President of All India Ophthalmological Society, as also presently the Chairman of Intraocular, Implant and Refractive Society. I am a graduate, a postgraduate, and an ex-faculty member from the prestigious All India Institute of Medical Sciences. When we are talking about laser vision correction, there are patients who are above 40 or 45 years of age, and they come to us asking that can we get rid of glasses both for distance and for near. Now, the problem as a person ages, that means a person becomes 45 years of age or more, is that the normal lens which is in an individual's eye, when a person is young, that lens has elasticity. So this lens, if it has got a curvature, it can change its curvature, and therefore by changing its curvature, it changes its power, and a person can see both for distance, intermediate, and also I would say for near. So these are the three distances that are used. One is distance. A lot of work is being done on the computer, that is intermediate, and when you are reading, say, a newspaper, etc., that is near. Now, the elasticity of this lens goes down with age, and therefore the lens which can earlier accommodate, the power of accommodation goes down, and a person is not able to change the power. So when we are doing laser vision correction, we correct only for one distance, that is for distance vision. So if a person says that, okay, no, I want to see near also, which is a requirement for everybody, and because there is a loss of elasticity in the lens, how do you compensate for that? So what is available nowadays is a procedure which is called as Presbyond. The need for glasses for reading being separate from distance, the disease or the condition is called as Presbyopia. That means, as I told you, loss of accommodation of the lens power is leading to dissimilar power that is required for distance and near. So presbyopia correction can be done by a technique which is called as Presbyond. Now, this technique of Presbyond, how does it work? The brain is something which has a huge amount of plasticity. It can fuse two dissimilar images. So what is done is that the dominant eye, a person has a dominant eye, like if you shoot, you which eye do you prefer for shooting? So if you use the right, then right is dominant. If you use the left, then left is dominant. So the dominant eye is corrected for distance vision, and the non-dominant eye you leave behind a minus power, or you induce a minus power, and that will help you for reading. In addition to that, this is called as monovision. That means one eye for distance, one eye for near, and in addition to that, you are also inducing something called as spherical aberration in Presbyond. So what this does is that two eyes, the vision goes to the brain and it fuses, even though the two eyes vision is dissimilar. That means this eye has a focus which is here, this eye has a focus here, but the brain is able to fuse both of these so that a person can have vision which is good for distance also and which is good for near. So whenever a person above 40-45 comes to us, we give a trial of what Presbyond would look like to a person in the glasses. And only if the person or the patient is able to tolerate this monovision with spherical aberration would we take this patient for Presbyond. So, and the other advantage of Presbyond is that supposing you give a patient monovision and the patient is not able to adjust to this, maybe 4 weeks, 5 weeks, then you can correct the residual power that you have left in the eye where you have made it good for near, and the person will have good vision for distance in both the eyes. So this is another technology that is important, and not all places have that. And we are happy to say that Center for Sight has this technology, which is called as Presbyond, which helps patients in the presbyopic age, that is patients above 40-45, to get good vision for distance as also good vision for near.
Follow Center for Sight and post your queries to get answers from the experts.